Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel on this very cold and frosty morning. I'm back with my Discovery 5 HSE Luxury and I'm going to be showing you how to fit the black pack to this car to take it from this to this. So brand new, I don't feel that the Discovery looks as good as it could look. It has the silver grille, the silver lettering. It looks quite plain unless you spec it up brand new with those extra features like the black pack, like the dynamic pack. So in this video, I'm gonna be telling you about three modifications you can make to your car really simply, really easily, all for less than around £600 to completely transform the way your vehicle looks. So the three parts I'm gonna be telling you about today are the lettering on the front and the rear. I'm gonna be telling you about the grille, the different types of grille you can get and the one that I think you should get because I think it looks the best. And then also the front vents low down on each side at the front of the vehicle, which are the vent fins that you see on the dynamic pack, which you could do yourself for about £50. So the first thing I'm gonna tell you about today is the lettering. So it's silver normally and I changed it to black, and that's probably because this car was black as well. I think black lettering looks really good. However, it does look good also on silver cars and on any color actually. I think it looks a lot more improved than the standard silver lettering that you get. So next up are the vent fins on the front bumper on the left and the right side. Now these are the vertical vents that you have on the bumper as standard. They're just big gaping holes essentially with nothing else in them at all, unless you choose a dynamic pack from factory. Now the pack that I fitted on this car, you think it's not going to make a huge difference to how the front looks, but actually it just helps tie it all in together really, really well. So I bought this pack from, I think it was eBay or Amazon. They were about £40-50 for the set, and actually to fit it wasn't bad at all. It was a really, really easy job. They are self-adhesive black plastic strips that, as long as you've cleaned the surface down and taken any residue off the surface, they just stick on. It was a really, really simple job to do, and I think makes a huge difference to how the front of the vehicle looks. It looks that much more aggressive with the fins on, particularly when it all ties in with the lettering and the front grille too. So last up, and I think the biggest change, is the front grille. So as standard, it's a silver grille with two bars with the Land Rover badge over on one side. Now, if you chose black pack from factory in these cars, you actually got the same grille, but it was just sprayed gloss black. However, you can also get the dynamic grille, which is the one I would say you want to be choosing, because the dynamic grille only came on the dynamic packs when you spec these cars up from new, and it's more of the honeycomb grille. It really updates the car, because the 2021 car has a very similar honeycomb grille at the front, so it looks quite similar to that actually. So my recommendation would be to go for the dynamic grille rather than just the black grille. So they can be bought either from Land Rover or they can be bought aftermarket. I can't comment on what the aftermarket ones are like. I got the original Land Rover Dynamic Black Grille for this car. I think it's one of those key points in the vehicle. I wanted to make sure it looked right, so I didn't go for any of the kind of dodgy, cheaper ones. The other thing to note as well is that when you buy the Dynamic Grille, it comes with a green Land Rover badge, which some people quite like. For me, I wanted to black out the whole front, so I actually bought a Land Rover badge which was black too, and again that badge just flicked straight out of the grille, and then cleaned it down, and then just get a brand new one that fits into the grille. Again, those parts really easy to get. They're not Land Rover original parts, but they do look exactly the same, and I'll put the link for that part as well in the description below this video. So let's go and have a look around the car. I'm going to show you those three parts, what they look like on the vehicle, and then I'm going to change the grille in this car at the moment, which is a silver two-bar grille, to the new dynamic gloss back grille. So let's go. So I'll start just by showing you the rear of the vehicle. So as you can see, this is the black lettering that has already been put on this car, which was fitted by Land Rover. And then let's go around to the front, and I'll show you those vents I was talking around. So at the front here, what you can see is these are the dynamic vents. It's this part and then these two as well, and these are just stuck onto the car, and I think they just give the car a much more aggressive look at the front. So let's now move on to the dynamic grille, and I'm going to show you how to fit that. So the first thing you need to do is lift up the bonnet, which is pretty easy on Discovery. Pop the bonnet clip, and then there's a little lever just there to open. Now when you look at the inside of the bonnet, what you'll see where the grille is there's four main screws. Once they're out, they're actually screws into rivets,
And once they're pulled, the screws are pulled out and the rivets are pulled out, the whole bumper simply unclips. So let's remove this grille to start with. So you've got these four screws that go into rivets, so they simply just unscrew out. The next thing to do is to remove these little plastic rivets. So these just come out, and the screws literally just go straight into them in the top, as you can see. So the grille I'm going to be fitting today is this grille, which is the Land Rover Dynamic Pack grille. And this is a grille, this is actually a Land Rover original grille, and that came on all Dynamic Pack cars. You can buy these online. As I say here, I'll put the price right here and where you can get them from. The links are in the description below this video too. So what they have on them is they have four little fasteners across the bottom that simply slide and insert into the bottom of the grille, and then they have those four rivet screws in the top. So you can see it's come loose now. That simply pulls out the bottom, it all unclips, and it comes off like that. And as you can see, when we've done that, these are where those little fasteners clip into in the bottom, and then obviously the screws in the top. Already looks much better when it's even near the car. And what you do to start with is line it up, and then slide those little fasteners into the bottom, all clips in like that. So that's all clipped in now, and now all we've got to do is put those plastic rivets back into these holes and then put the screws back in, and it's as simple as that. I hope this video has been useful to show you how you can do this yourself so easily and really transform the look of your Discovery 5. If you've got any comments or suggestions, please drop them in the comment box below. And also remember to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and I'll be putting more content out coming very soon.